The number one question that I get asked every single day is, Sinead, how do I become a web developer? Usually my answer is, learn the basics. Now, the most people when they hear this answer just don't want to listen. And then they start searching for some special solution, some secret language, some secret framework, some secret method, the best course out there and stuff like that. But really, the answer doesn't lay there. So let me explain what do I mean by that. If we, for example, use one sentence, and if I write here, my name is Sinead. Okay? Now, when we analyze this lesson, we can see that this sentence have different words, okay? And then each word have different letters, okay? So now we can came up to the realization that if we want to know to say some sentence, first we need to learn the letters, okay? After that, we need to learn how to combine those letters to create words. And after that, we need to learn how to combine words in order to create sentences. And in order to create speech, we need to learn how to create sentences, and so on and so on. For example, if we think about math, and if in math we have something simple like, okay, and now we need to solve this, we can see that we have different operators, we can see that we have numbers, and so on. So in order to be able to solve this entire equation, we need first to learn operators, after that to learn numbers, and then, I mean, learn the digits 0 to 9, and after that use these digits to create numbers, then use numbers and operators to create equations, and so on and so on. So now, as you can see, in every aspect of our life, if everything that we know and that we probably like use as granted, we first needed to learn the small things, the basics of it, in order to be able to do something else, to do and bigger things. So now, if we think about web development in particular, most people when they start, first thing they want to do is like, I want to send an email. I want to create my own website. Okay, that's fine. But first you need to break down everything in that website that you want to create to the basic stuff, then learn that basic stuff, and then go and put everything together. So, for example, let's say you want to have a website like this, okay? So here you're gonna have some logo, and then here you're gonna have some menu, okay? And then here maybe you want to have some headline, okay? Maybe you want to have some opt-in form, and then you can have some like posts from your blog here, and so on. Okay, so now when we analyze this, first you need to learn, you can see that this website consists of different columns, it consists of different rows, it consists of images, of text, of links, and so on. So in order for you to be able to learn this, you first need to learn all those basic stuff that you have in one particular website. After that, you need to master those so that you are able to put them together and put them on the different ways so that you can create the design that you want to, And after that, you need to go and learn something else. You need to know how to create a bigger functionality like sending an emails. But before that, you need to master the basics of, I will say, HTML to create a form, CSS to create nice design. You need to learn how to have the forms work. You need to learn the basics of PHP, okay? You need to learn the functions, the variables, the constants, the conditions, and so on. So, guys, here's the thing. The purpose of this video is, I hopefully have explained that don't search for another method. Don't search for another framework. Don't search for another course. Just learn the basics, master those. Be able to combine all the things that you have learned previously, and after that, go and search for another thing that you need to learn. So, in my course, that if you want to check here, I explain all of those basics, and I explain in a certain way so that you can understand, so that you can learn how, when we go to the next lesson, that you know how to combine that knowledge with everything that you learned before. Because as you can see here, that is the key point on how to become a web developer. The answer doesn't lay in framework, language, and other stuff. So I hope that you will find this video useful, that you will listen to me, and that you will become a web developer. If you like this video, please like it and share it with your friends. And of course, I will be happy to read your comments and answer all of them. Let me know in the comments below what do you think.